So hi guys and welcome back to making Kush Moini a Formula One champion. And in this series, we are right now in a new part here. And look at that, guys. We have some changes in the driver points because look at that. We are now with Kush Moini going 77-88. Lance Stroll goes 77-88. Guan Yu Zhou goes down a little. And let's see, Max Verstappen's rating does not change. Fernando Alonso goes 89-88. Now Charles Leclerc, Carlos Sainz, Lewis Hamilton, Lando Norris and George Russell goes one up. Alexander Albon and Oscar Piastri goes up, and Logan Sargeant goes to 68-88. That's not really good, so let's update that. And guys, I have to say something about this. I messed up. I, while recording, did not see what was happening, and I did 3 races with this. Obviously, I was having fun. I thought, let's just keep on doing the races, and I did not see that my OBS wasn't properly working. And because of that, guys, you will have to see this. I have only done one race in which, well, Kush Moini's career mode and 2 in my driver career mode. So I think Kush Moini's career mode isn't going to be hurt too much. So we are skipping past the time, guys, again. And obviously the race will be fine, guys. The race will be fine because we have replay cams for that. And look at that, we have 4 big upgrades coming in for Belgian race here. So guys, let's just go into the qualifying. But before that, look at that, guys. 4 upgrades coming in which we have 2 major upgrades and 3 minors. And look at that, how much we develop from GB, well, Great Britain to Spa. Look at that, we are almost so close to the top 4. So guys, let's just first see here. We have points to buy another drag reduction upgrade for aerodynamics, and we have purchased that, and we buy another minor upgrade for ERS cooling. So guys, let's just go into the qualifying.
And dramatic corners, what is there not to love about today? It's qualifying day here at Spa-Francorchamps.
So into the qualifying, doing our first run here, obviously on our inter tires, because the whole race, the whole qualifying session was on inter. So first lap turn goes to P7, but second lap here, purple, first sector green, second, and we go P7 again. So look at that, only a 10th slower than Kush Moini here. Obviously, I skip past the time here. No one at the end went out, so the rain must have gotten heavier, and that's why we didn't go out. So we were 100% into Q2. So here, Q2, obviously you can at least see more or less everything other than the gearbox, ERS and anything. So wet lap here, we go P1 on our wet tires with a 159.0. What's happening? Purple first sector, second sector only a 10th lower than that, and 2/10 on our third sector than purple. So final lap here on in Q2, purple first sector, purple second sector on inter tires. Obviously everyone else is also on inter. Magnussen in P7, we are right now P8, and we go P1 again, and our teammate Pierre Gasly goes P3. And look at that, guys, George Russell, Oscar Piastri, Max Verstappen and Carlos Sainz, he is in P15, and all of these guys are out because they did not go on a wet tires. And that's what I'm saying, guys, this is the mistake they have done. So Q3 here, the rain is getting lighter and lighter, and we are right now on inters doing our first lap here, and we go with the first time only P7. So not the best time here. So let's go on a new set of inters together. We are right now P7, our teammate is in P10. I think he can improve, so can we. And I think, guys, so a final lap into Q3 here, through the bus stops again, purple first sector, green second sector. We are crossing the line and we do not know where we go, and we are P2, 3/10 slower than Lando Norris. Lando Norris goes on pole, guys, and Pierre Gasly P10, and let's go into the race.
Welcome then, as we take a step back into the nostalgic golden days of motorsport. Spa is unashamedly a throwback, and all the better for it. Climbs, drops, sharp turns, chicanes, sweeping high-speed corners, all while taking in some of the most beautiful scenery that Europe has to offer. This might sound like a travel brochure, but it's not. It's a race day. Welcome along to Spa-Francorchamps for the Belgian Grand Prix. Spa-Francorchamps today, a circuit that spans 4.35 miles. There are tons of elevation changes along the way too. 19 corners making up this circuit, with 9 of those to the right and the remaining 10 to the left. This track's a great one for fans of pure speed, and the average lap speed comes close to a whopping 145 miles per hour. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Kush Maini completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Perez, Ricciardo, Fernando Alonso, Tsunoda, Leclerc, Magnussen, Gasly, Russell, Oscar Piastri, Verstappen, Joe, Stroll, Sargeant, Albon, Bottas, Hülkenberg, and Carlos Sainz will start from the back of the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. And alongside me in the commentary box, my old friend, Anthony Davidson. Now, we had great fun watching them win last time out. What a great victory it was. But can they carry that into today's race?
It's the important one, isn't it, Crofty? You've done it once. Can you do it again? But, you know, if you start believing in yourself and the confidence starts to build, that inner confidence is what you need. And you can carry that through to future races, including this one. And you set that ball rolling. That's the critical thing that they're looking for here. And I believe if you've got that first race win or a win at any stage, it can start to roll with you in a good way.
Obviously, Lando Norris is leading the championship and he is in P1. So, a simple strategy from medium to hard tires and let's go. 3 lights, 4 lights, 5 lights. And we are a go for the Spa GP here, Spa-Francorchamps, and Max Verstappen is down the order, and because of that we are here fighting with Lando Norris and into turn 1. Tried to make a bit of a dive bomb, did not work, but we are still with Lando Norris, and Perez has overtaken Ricciardo there. Ricciardo is in a lofty P5 here. Pierre Gasly has gone down to P11. Tsunoda, Magnussen and Alonso are also looking good. So Magnus and Alonso going side by side here for the whole straight. Can they overtake anyone? Nope. They are still going side by side. And look at that. It's 3 wide. It's 3 wide with Charles Leclerc, George Russell and Kevin Magnussen. They are not letting this one go still. And turn 9 here. Still going side by side into turn 9. And we are still 3 wide. And finally, Magnussen gives out. And he has let both of these cars by. Obviously makes sense because they are the faster cars, so let's keep on him. And Lando Norris has already broken DRS to us. So lap 2 here, Max Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton overtakes us, but it's a strategy, guys. We are letting Lewis Hamilton by, because look at that, that's the DRS detection point, and we now get the DRS and we can now stay with Lewis Hamilton. Obviously we are not going to overtake him now. We are going to overtake him on the Camel Straight, and let's go till then. So we are still only 4 tenths behind him. We can catch up, and without any problem we will overtake him. So let's go through the Arouge here and up the area. And look at that, guys, we have caught up a lot here because the soft tires are not letting these guys push enough. So we are here with the help of DRS and getting out of the way from his slipstream and into the braking. We overtake without any problem Lewis Hamilton, and we are again back into P1. And look at that, lap 5 here. Lando Norris is 7 seconds in front of us, but these guys are not able to overtake us, because look at that, they are fighting crazy. Even Perez tried to fight there a little bit, and we are going toe to toe with Lewis Hamilton, going side by side through Arouge, and we have overtaken Lewis Hamilton. But we have to see that again. Look at that, guys. Lewis Hamilton, obviously, we had to give him a little bit of space there, but we were able to do so. We are still going side by side with Albon Pirès and the Tsunoda, and Ricardo obviously is trying to fight with us, but Tsunoda is now trying to overtake Lewis Hamilton through the Lacombe chicane. Wasn't able to do. They are doing a good job. So lap 7 here, guys. Pirès has broken DRS to us this time, but we are still only 3.6 seconds behind him. So we can still catch up to these guys. Obviously, they are on softs and I am on medium. So I will catch up all this deficit at the end with a medium tires run. Sorry, soft tires run. So we will see that. So lap 9 here, Charles Leclerc is deciding that he will pit and do a undercut on the people in front. Piastri is still P11. Look at that, guys. This is a DRS train from P4, which is Lewis Hamilton, to P13, which is Lance Stroll. So let's see, Lewis Hamilton doing good, and Charles Leclerc did not get a good pit stop here, so he comes out in P18. And lap 10 here, Lando Norris also decides that he wants to pit, and we are here with catching to, and we have a spin. That is, I think, Daniel Ricciardo. Yep, that is Daniel Ricciardo in the RB. He was doing such an amazing job in P5 there. Has just spun out, and what is he doing? He is not moving out of the way. What's he waiting for? I don't know, because the cars are more or less not there. So we are here. Look at that. Obviously, we had a objective to get a good lap time here, but look at that. We are here only 2 seconds behind Pirès. We have caught up to him by 1.7, and look at that. First, it was a safety car, and we kept on going and going, and then what happened? Obviously, I did cut the corner because we were just trying to go green. Well, try to stay our delta in green, and we are now might be able to get a pit stop, but the game decided we need a red flag. The game decided we needed a red flag for a simple spin. So we can now go on softs a lap earlier. I think that soft tires run will be, but I think we can manage those tires pretty much okay. Obviously, everyone will be on medium. So 3 lights, 4 lights, 5 lights, and we're gonna go for the restart of Spa GP. We are P2 with Pirès, P1 here. Lando Norris has gone to P3 after his pit stop, and we are here from the around the outside. We overtake Sergio Pirès, and look at that, our teammate Pierre Gasly also got really lucky. He goes from P9, P11 to P4, and obviously Daniel Ricciardo goes to P19 after his spin, and Oscar Piastri is also in P6. George Russell, all of these guys who were like on the fringes of the points, they are now really high up, so they can, I think, do something. So George Russell and Oscar Piastri going side by side through the Lacombe chicane, and they have done it. Russell has now overtaken Oscar Piastri, and we will now have a fight, I think. And look at that, guys. In just half a lap, I have broken DRS. Obviously, I used all the battery I had to do that, but Pirès did not let this one go that easily. He has gotten back us into the DRS again. So we are going to keep with him. Lap 14, he has caught up to our DRS a lot, and we are again playing the DRS chicken with these guys. And look at that, Lando Norris also trying to overtake us, but now we're going side by side here, but I get a better exit because I went a little bit on a U-shape. So we are here 6 tenths behind Sergio Pirès. Lap 15, I think we can overtake him, and we go wide again. Did not get a penalty, that's good news. And we are here 5 tenths here, not using our battery, but using our DRS, and we are just a little bit behind this time. But on lap 16, we are this time close. We are even using our battery here, if you can see down there, and with the help of our ERS, we overtake Sergio Pirès and even go wide in the chicane there. But we have done it. We overtake Sergio Pirès for the lead. Back again, guys. We can do something here. We can do something here. So let's keep on these guys and keep with these guys, because their medium tires will start to get better in a lap or two. So lap 17 here, we are still in front of Pirès, but Pirès has overtaken us, and it's because I slowed down to let him by because we want the DRS on the camel straight, which will be helpful. So we are again not letting Lando Norris by that easily. We are still in P2 and we will get DRS here on the camel straight and we will again overtake him. But look at that, guys. George Russell has not been able to overtake Pierre Gasly. That's something to see. So with the help of DRS, and we have again overtaken Sergio Perez without any problem. But we go a little bit harder on the tires there, and because of that, Perez has caught up to us again. But well, we are playing DRS chicken without any problem, so I think we can do it, and we can still do something here. So look at that, 4 tenths behind. And lap 19, Perez is still in front. Lap 20, Perez is still in front. So we are now, I think the tires are going a little bit, so we will have to start to worry about that. But still, the good news is, look at that, the from P1 to P6 there is a DRS train which no one can break out of, and Magnussen was in P20. So we are here with Mainyi. Look at that, we have not using DRS, just simply DRS here, and we have overtaken Sergio Perez here. Still going side pressure through the Lecoms again, and pushing a little bit wide Sergio Perez, but he has done it, and we have overtaken him for P1, and we are back into the lead, guys. This is the third time we are doing the lead here, and lap 20 here, we are just behind Perez. Obviously we can still win this race, but I'm not going to let this by that easily, because I obviously, guys, if I lead the race in P1 at this point in time at the camel straight, I will lose too much time. So again, guys, same repeating here with the help of DRS, and we again overtake Sergio Perez, but he tried to go side by side with us, and we go a little bit deep there. So Sergio Perez still was side by side, but we gave him a little bit of a pinch, and because of that we are still here. So at the end of lap 21, look at that, guys, the tires are 47%, so they are crying now. And into the bus stops again. Look at that, fastest lap is for Sergio Perez, and we have a problem. We are out of the race. No, guys, come on, that was not good. This is the third time, guys, this is the third time in this race, in this season, we were leading a race and we have to retire out of the race. And Pierre Gasly is going to score more points than us again. This is not good, guys. We were so close to getting that win. We were just starting our final lap there, guys. And we were in front this time. Obviously, I had battery saved up.
Lando Norris, take a bow. At last, a winner in Formula One.
And it's always good, Crofty, to get that momentum on your side. And it's really good for your confidence as well. The more confident you are, the further that can take you.
As the winners make their way up to the podium, one can only imagine the celebrations that will take place at McLaren tonight. Congratulations to everyone on the team, securing the win and proving that they're a force to be reckoned with out on the track.
So Lando Norris obviously won at George Russell, getting a podium after someone in front DNF. That is not something new. So I mean, guys, I don't know. I think the game is against us at this point, because this is the third time I was leading the race. Obviously in Austria I wasn't really leading the race, but I was in the contention of getting some good points. In Australia, which was the second race, we were actually still P2, P3, and again we got a mechanical fault. So guys, I think they have something in the coding which says I cannot lead or be in P2, P3 in the first season, or I will get DNF'd out of the race. That's the best thing I can say. And look at that, we lose 1500 focus. That's not good. Obviously, we have completed the season objective of getting 78 rated because of the update we had. So guys, if you are enjoying these videos, and please, I do say sorry for the mistake I did with the recording. So guys, please like and subscribe to the video, and I'll see you for the next one.